You're here because your utility has asked you to collect a 5th liter sample. 5 bottles, 5 liters. So you might not know what that means, but we're here to show you how it's done. Under the Environmental Protection Agency, or the EPA's new lead and copper rule revisions, which start in January 2025, your local utility will be required to collect samples that contain the 5th liter of water that comes from outside your home in your water service line. During this sampling, you will have one sample that is the 1st liter and you'll have the 5th liter. The 1st liter will represent the water that is stagnant within your faucets and piping within the home, and the 5th liter will represent the water outside your home within the water service line. Sampling this way will provide a more accurate reading of the lead levels within your home if you use a water service line that is made of lead or have any lead fixtures or piping within your home as well. Let's get started. You have received a box of sampling materials from your utility company. Make sure you read the included instructions in full before you start collecting, and make sure that you plan ahead to sample correctly. We recommend collecting all samples first thing in the morning or after everyone has been out the house all day, since the water has to be sitting untouched for at least 6 hours. This means no turning on the tap, flushing the toilet, or running appliances like the dishwasher or washer. You can put up notes to remind others not to use the water during this 6 hour period. Review the forms provided within your kit and take note of the times and information you will need to keep track of while sampling. Remember, you will need to note the time that water was last used before sampling. Other things to note: make sure the last water you used before the waiting period was cold water. Do not rinse or remove any aerators. If you have a filter on your faucet, follow the instructions from your utility to properly sample around it or remove it before collecting your samples. Let's start collecting the samples. Give yourself room by clearing the counter space around your kitchen or bathroom sink for all of the sampling bottles and form. Remove the tops and line up the wide mouth sample bottles in order from 1 to 5 near the faucet. If you have to write anything on the bottles, like the date or the time, make sure you do so before adding the water. Have a phone, a watch, or clock at the ready to take note of the time when you start sampling. If there is someone in your home who can help collect the samples, we find that having someone nearby to hand off the full bottles to or read the instructions helps the process run more smoothly. When you are ready to begin, first, write down your start time. Secondly, place the first bottle below the faucet and do not touch the inside of the bottle with your fingers or the faucet itself. Turn the faucet to cold water to start immediately filling the first bottle. Run the water as you fill up a glass of water and let the water run continuously as you collect all 5 samples. Try not to lose any water when transferring between bottles, if possible. Have the next bottle in the other hand or have someone ready to hand the bottle to as you finish up the previous bottle. Fill the bottle to the bottom of the neck of the bottle. After all the bottles are filled, replace the caps without touching the inside of the bottles with your fingers. It does not matter which cap goes on which bottle. Next, complete the sampling collection form. If you are shipping the samples back, get the return box ready and make sure the return label is on the box properly. You only need to ship the full bottles labeled 1 and 5 back. Make sure that these bottles are sealed tightly before adding them to the box. Seal up the box with the samples and any other forms required. After everything is safely packaged, dump all the other remaining samples and dispose of these bottles as instructed. If your samples are being picked up, review how your utility would like the bottles packaged and if they need all 5 sample bottles full or just bottles 1 and 5. Complete all relevant documentation and let them know the samples are ready to pick up. You're all set for now. To comply with the EPA's new lead and copper rule revisions, your utility company will ask you in about 6 months or a year to sample again. And if you do, thank you so much for helping your utility stay on top of the lead levels within your community. For more information about lead in drinking water, please visit your utility's website or the EPA website. Thank you.